or not. Like I said, the sooner the lambs are, the harder it's going to be for them to. Okay, so when we walk them, you want to put one hand under their chin. I know that's not possible when they're not broken. And the other hand just gently on the back as a push. So you want to, the last
and
thing
you guys, want. Guys, you got to keep distance between you. Make sure, don't ever get within 2 feet of anybody. Because that's very important.
Yeah, we'll get there. But right now, back to how we're going to walk. What you want to do is not make it look like you're pulling on the lamb to get through them. I mean, if I'm judging the showmanship class and you're having to pull it the whole time, then I already know you haven't spent any time with them. You're not going to win. But if you have spent time with your lamb, then you're going to be able to walk with it like this, which I can't do because this lamb isn't quite broken enough yet. But you're going to have to put one hand underneath it. And then you're just going to make it feel as easy as possible to walk your lamb. While you're looking at the judge and making sure you're leaving a good distance between your lamb and the next lamb. Why is it so important to leave distance? Yes, and because showmanship is all about, if you're a good lamb showman, your lamb could not be as good as the one next to you. But in a regular class, you might be able to do that because you've been able to show it better than they have. You've been able to brace better, flex its muscles better, and you may win because of that. So when you're separate, when you leave space, the judge can see what you got going on better. So you're basically in a modeling competition with your lamb, and you're trying to downplay things that make it not so pretty and play up the things that make it that's one of the reasons you want to leave room is so if the person in front of you stops really quickly, you don't ram yours head up